afternoon, everybody, and welcome to your terrific Tuesday afternoon Devo. Part 2 of episode 603. Just clicking them right along after hitting the big one. But today, for Tuesday, January 18th, your daily bread passage, we're going to be talking about love's greatest gift. From James Banks, B-A-N-K-S, like Banks of the River. Derived from Isaiah 53, 1 through 6. So if you're excited about this, well, smash the like button. Comment what has been your greatest gift with love. What do you think love's greatest gift is before you start hearing this? I know you'll be hearing all this, but put your prediction down what love's greatest gift is all about. Put your predictions down now in the comments. But, subscribe if you're new, turn on notifications, share the video and channel with your family and friends, and help me reach that 100 subscriber mark. Get my channel to grow. That's all I can ask. If you do that for me, I will appreciate it. And maybe like I said in this morning's video, the new channel may start growing. It may grow more than this one. So, stay tuned into that channel. When I do get the channel up, I'll put a link. There should be a link. All you gotta do is look up Falco Joe 2 and you'll be able to go to the other channel. And if you haven't seen any of those videos I put over there, go do them now. Go watch, because there was like 2 or 3 days of Devos that I couldn't put on my regular channel. I had to put them over there just to have them, to be able to post them. And I don't know, and put it in the comment section and let me know, all y'all that are used to doing things, how do I get the videos from there back over on this channel? Because I don't know whether I still got them on my flash drive or not. Do I just go get that channel up, download them to my computer, and then turn around, go back to the original channel, and upload them there? Upload them that way. I don't know. Just let me know in the comments. So. But like I said, the other channel should grow. Start growing pretty soon once I get the camera and everything to go out and do the videos I'm going to do. So, because I sure can't take this computer out and do film videos. I have to have a mobile camera to be able to take it out, because I thought about, because I had the computer with me on my birthday trip, which that's what the shirt's from. This is a shirt I wore, and I put it on Saturday and I didn't take it off until Monday when I got home, because I didn't know what to do, so I just kept it. I didn't have a hotel room to go change, so. But I'll get in that later, but. Just let me know that way. But I planned on going over to the golf place there in Nashville. Because it was over by the mall there. I'd plan on going in there, pulling the computer out. I guess I would have to pull it off to run the camera. So I didn't have to hold the thing, and I had one of the workers help me out by carrying it for me. For them to run it for me while I run through the one. I think I was just going to do the one course that I wanted to do, and well, I could not find the daggum bus to take me over there. So, but love's greatest gift. Let's get back to it. Sorry for rambling. I get talking about something, I start rambling. Sorry. James Banks, he writes, my son Jeff, G-E-O-F-F, Jeff, not G-J-E-F-F, it's G-O-G-E-O-F-F, was leaving a store when he saw an abandoned walking frame, a mobility aid on the ground. I guess one of those walkers or whatever that people use and the older people use to walk with, and they help keep them hold up by they put it out in front of them, take a few steps. Put it out in front of them, take a few steps. Those. He found it on the ground. I hope there isn't a person back there who needs help, he thought. So he glanced behind the building and found a homeless man unconscious on the pavement. Jeff roused him and asked if he was okay. I'm trying to drink myself to death, he responded.
Ooh.
Excuse me, nose itches. Ah. Yeah, I've got my jacket on because it's a little cooler out here, so just being prepared, because the other night I did that and it was cooler out here and I dreaded it, so keep my arms warm. He responded, my tent broke in a storm and I lost everything. I don't want to live. Jeff called a Christian rehab ministry while they waited for help. He ran home briefly and brought the man his own camping tent. What's your name? Jeff asked. Jeffrey, the homeless man answered, with a G. Jeff hadn't mentioned his own name or its uncommon spelling. Dad, he told me later, that could have been me. Oh, Jeff was talking to his dad, which is James. That could have been me. And Jeff once struggled with substance abuse himself, and he helped the man because of the kindness he received from God. So Isaiah the prophet had used these words to anticipate God's mercy to us in Jesus. We all like sheep have gone astray. Each of us has turned his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. Isaiah 53 verse 6. And that was the verse at the top of the page. And the only part that got it says, we all like sheep have gone astray. It's the only part up there, but then the whole verse is down there. So Christ our Savior didn't leave us lost, alone, and hopeless in despair. He chose to identify with us and lift us up in love so that we may be set free to live anew in Him. There's no greater gift. And I think it's love, joy, and there's another third thing to it. But the greatest of all is love. Love is the greatest gift of all. So where would you be without Jesus? And if you don't have Jesus, consider making Him part of your life, because you'll be glad you did. And if you don't know how, find somebody that does. You know there's probably some friends of yours that are Christians or go to church. And if you don't know today, if you'll die right now, if you'll wake up in heaven, if you don't know that for sure, get hold of somebody to help you make sure. Because you will regret it if you don't. I'm sharing the good news. That's all I do. I share the good news. So, but where would you be without Jesus? If you're a Christian, where would you be without Him? So how can you be his hands and feet for someone in need? So if you see somebody in need, stop and find out if they need help. Because you will be, it will warm your heart if you do something like that. But ponder that by saying, thank you, Jesus, for coming to rescue me. Help me to join in your search and rescue mission and to share your love with someone who needs you today. So, for more or further study about this idea, read Remade in the Image of Jesus at discoveryseries.org/remade. Not a number this time. Usually it's a number. But discoveryseries.org/remade. And I'll be sure to link that description. I'll be sure to link that website in the description box below. Or in the description box below the video. If you've got the comment section is. You'll have the info about the thing, the description of the video. There should be a link. I'll make sure to put the link in the description. But your Bible reading today is Genesis 43-45 and Matthew 12:24-50. The rest of Matthew chapter 12. So coming up tomorrow in part 2 of 604, we're going to be talking about Stay Awake from Marvin Williams. And it's derived from Matthew 26:36-46. So basically reading this one, you'll probably remember, if you've read today's Matthew Bible verse, you'll be reading tomorrow's Devo, where the Devo is derived from. You'll be reading tomorrow's passage. Because you're reading 26:46-46. Oh, wait a minute. Wrong. Sorry about that. It's Matthew 12. This is Matthew 26. Sorry, I'm just getting ahead of myself. I was like, wait a minute. Wrong chapter. I'm getting ahead of myself. But Stay Awake from Marvin Williams tomorrow. Coming up at 7 o'clock tonight, we're going to learn how to give to the giver. Beginning with 1 Chronicles 29:14. Recommended reading is James 1:17-18. Jerry Bridges has the turning point, quote, and then your Bible reading in that one is Exodus 8-10. So look at that. In today's daily bread, Genesis 43-45. So there's still 5 more chapters left in Genesis for the daily bread. But here, it's 8, 9, and 10 of Exodus. Oh boy. But I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God, and He'll keep you safe in all you say and do in 2022. And until later, peace out, everybody. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your terrific Tuesday afternoon. Come back tonight for Give to the Giver. That should be a good one. But until then, goodbye.